Hello Aries, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you for the last 15 days of March. And as these are general readings, they won't be resonating with each and every one of you. Maybe your energies of the person or the situation you're dealing with, or maybe the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. For the personal readings, the details are given in the description box below. Okay. So let's see what's going on or what's coming up for my Aries for the, I should say, last 15 days of March. So let's see what's there for Aries. Messages for Aries, please. Okay, so we have the High Priestess, the Knight of Swords, the Nine of Swords, the Temperance, the Ace of Swords, Page of Swords, Queen of Pentacles, the Two of Pentacles, and the Knight of Pentacles. Okay, so Aries, you have perhaps in the recent past, what I feel is that you have perhaps rushed in towards something very, very impulsively, though your intuition did tell you deep within, somehow you knew that you shouldn't move in that fast, but still you did it anyway. Okay, what I feel here is you didn't listen to your intuition. Okay, your intuition told you that movement should be slow, you shouldn't be rushing in towards this, or you shouldn't be moving towards this path or towards this person. There has been something which was stopping you. Your inner voice was constantly guiding you, and somehow what I feel is that you did not listen to your inner voice and you just rushed in towards this this person or this situation, and the result was that there has been something which has not worked out over here. Okay, so your plans have fall back, or whatever your thing was, you are not successful in it because you didn't listen to your inner voice. You have ignored, or you've done something which has, you've overlooked something perhaps. There has been something which has caused a failure in this plan of yours, or there has been, at least if not an entire failure, then there is something which is, at least some aspect of this has not worked out, and there is something which is causing you a lot of tension and a lot of anxiety. The only thing here is the thing which you have done is that you didn't listen to your intuition all along. Okay, and then we have in the current situation, we have the Temperance, the Ace of Swords, and the Page of Wands. So there is a need to be balanced. There's a need to balance this situation emotionally as well as within you and outside you. So this is something going on after this endless anxiety, endless tension, a lot of overthinking, and maybe you have even, I don't know why I'm getting this, but I think maybe you have occurred some sort of loss. It can be a financial loss, it can be some other loss, but it is something that you are really, 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 really repenting on this decision. Actually, whatever this decision was in which you rushed in, or whatever that thing was, you are really, really regretting very hard and repenting. It is like you're just covering your face and just crying, okay, oh, why didn't I listen to my intuition? Why the hell, how the hell could I do this mistake? And like, it's not me, and I normally listen to my intuition all the time. This is the only time I just rushed in towards it, and oh my god, why I didn't listen to my intuition, and why the hell did I land up in this situation? Okay, but and that, because of this, there is a major desire and the requirement also, I should say, of balancing things out, and that is what you are doing, and you are successful in it. So okay, whatever has happened, you are able to balance the situation, you're able to sort it out, and you have the clarity slowly and steadily. Once you are out of this anxiety and tension, the period which you are going through, or you must have been going through, once you are able to balance it, you will realize the clarity as to in which direction you're now supposed to move forward. So you will definitely have a new beginning and a clarity as to now how things should be accomplished. And with the Page of Wands here, you are definitely moving slowly and steadily towards something new. So it is definitely a new beginning over here. Once you are able to come out of whatever it is, you will be having a new beginning, and you will be taking a small step towards it also. So a new beginning is coming in, or has already come in your current situation or in your present. Okay, and in the near future, what I feel is we have the Queen of Pentacles, the Two of Pentacles, and the Knight of Pentacles. So what I feel here is that you are still reflecting upon the direction, the new direction or the new situation or the person, whatever this is, which is new in your life. You are taking time to contemplate and review it. You are taking the time to decide. With the Queen of Pentacles and the Two of Pentacles, you are now wise enough to go slow, to view all the pros and cons, because you really don't want to commit the same mistake. You don't want to act impulsively. Here you have acted impulsively. You've moved in impulsively. You were very emotional. You just rushed in towards the situation. But this time you want to correct it. You don't want to repeat the same mistake. So you are just giving it a thought. Maybe you have just put in the first step towards this situation or this person. But still, you are taking your own time and you are really, really moving very slow with the Knight of Pentacles. So it is with the Two of Pentacles, the Knight of Pentacles, the Queen of Pentacles, you are taking all the time you need to weigh all the pros and cons. You are, analyzing every situation, every move, every step. You are not hurrying this time. So with from the Knight of Swords, you have come to the Knight of Pentacles. And it is a very good decision over here, because now you're moving slow, but you are steady. You are slow, you are steady, and you are going in to build a stable foundation. So that is what your motive is. So I think you've learned the lesson of moving in impulsively. Okay, so yes, in the present situation you do have a new beginning, and in the near future you will definitely be taking definite steps to move slowly and steadily in that direction. The guidance from this deck is, yes, the Queen of Diamonds. This is spirituality. This is meditation. This is listening to your inner voice once again. So again, this is coming up as a guidance for you. So listen to your inner voice. Just, and if there is a lot of anxiety still in your heart and in your mind, then do the meditation, do the healing. So you just need to give time to yourself to heal. If you feel that still the things are there which are still on your mind from the past, then you just need to take it slow and focus on your healing. And once you are able to do that, you will be able to have clarity as to which direction to move forward and how to move forward. So let's see what is the guidance from the angels for Aries. The spiritual teacher, number 9, may be of some significance for you. So there are great rewards in spending time alone. Use those moments of solitude to focus on love and ways in which you might give to those around you. Shine your light as an example for others to follow. Seek out a spiritual mentor of your own if your life feels unfulfilled right now. So Aries, that's all I have for you. Hope it helps. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Let's meet in the next video. Bye.